IVM.
On this episode of Paisa, Vaisa, I wrap up my three-part series on asset allocation. Remember, in the first part, we did the introduction to asset allocation. In the second part, we spoke about the process of asset allocation. In this third part, we are going to talk about the execution of asset allocation, the value of financial advice. My guest in all three episodes is Radhika Gupta, CEO of Edelweiss Asset Management. So stay tuned for that.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another awesome week on IVM Podcast. If you aren't following us on social media, please make sure you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. On Instagram, we've been doing an interesting thing recently. What we're trying to do is whenever a listener is listening, they take a screenshot of what they're listening to, they make a comment, and they tag us on it. And we're reposting that on all of our stories. So, I mean, like, if you want to get on our feed, then please do tag us. And otherwise, if you want to see what other people are listening, then go and check out the Instagram account and you can take a look at that. On Cyrus Says, Cyrus is joined by Revathi Roy. She takes Cyrus through her entrepreneurial journey and her fondness for cars and driving. On Puliyabazi, the host discussed how the U.S. reached the position of a world leader and what are the odds of China replicating that feat. Speaking of Puliyabazi, they were also featured in a Scroll magazine article talking about how English-speaking urbanites are interested in listening to content in Hindi languages. Check out the article on our Instagram highlights section. On IVM Likes, comedian Supriya Joshi joins the IVM gang to talk about pop culture they consume in non-English languages. Last week, we launched a brand new Hindi podcast called Cinemaya. It's hosted by Swati Bakshi and our first guest is Nandita Das. She discusses her journey as a woman filmmaker in a male-dominated industry. And with that, let's continue on with your show.
Folks, welcome to Paisa Vaisa. I'm your host Anupam Gupta, B50 on Twitter. And this is the third of our three-part series on asset allocation with Radhika Gupta, CEO of Edelweiss Asset Management. In part one, we spoke about the intro, the basics of asset allocation. In the second part, we spoke about the entire framework of asset allocation, the process of asset allocation, the five-step process. In this third and final part, we're going to talk about the execution, right? I'm sure that a lot of you are probably wondering, you've given me all these basics, now tell me how to execute it. Lots of ways, actually. And this is going to be, it's an important part of all your investments. You can take your decisions on your own. You could probably go online and get a lot of help because there are a lot of calculators out there, a lot of fintech companies out there. Or you could just go to your friendly neighborhood financial advisor and figure that out. This third part is going to be exactly on this, the value of financial advice. Radhika, welcome back to the show. Let's get into all this, okay? 10, 12 years ago, the industry, from what I remember, I don't think the role of a financial advisor was threshed out that well. There was zero fintech companies, okay? I'm sure you took your decision. You spoke about how in 2007, 2008, you were maximum invested in equities, okay? I knew that I also was at that point of time. And there was no financial advice there. Flash forward to 10 years, 2018, and now there's like bharpoor. Aapko jo advice chahiye, aapko milega. Mutual funds sahi hai, Twitter pe jao, ye hota hai, Facebook pe jao, wo hota hai, WhatsApp pe kuch ho raha hai, and everybody suddenly become a gyani. Tell me the value of financial advice. I mean, let's get really deep into this topic about what someone who's new to investment, someone who really doesn't know too much about it, someone who doesn't have time, okay, because I know for a fact for any investment professional, whether that's you or whether that's anybody else who's working in the industry, you guys have earned your degrees. You do this for a living. I don't. Okay. So how do I manage this journey of investments? Tell us.
Okay. So I do lots of investor camps across the country. And, you know, people write me on Twitter and I get lots of questions. And I get questions like, you know, I'm 25. Where should I park my assets, ma'am? Or, you know, someone asked me that there are 40 mutual fund companies and 2000 schemes. How do I pick? And if I had to give a one line answer to each one of those questions, it would be, please find yourself a good financial advisor. And now let me tell you why. And before finance, I want to talk about life a little philosophically. I think in every domain of life, we know the need for advice. So a good politician historically needed Chanakya to give him political advice, right? A great sports personality needs a coach to give him financial advice. And even a good doctor will tell you when he's getting knee surgery, he needs a senior doctor to give him advice. So you recognize that advice is important in all domains because, as you very correctly said, these are professional things. Finance is also very, very professional. And that's why you need financial advice. I think there are two more things. 20 years ago, when you started investing in markets, it was really about FDs, post office plan, etc., etc., realize that markets have gotten a lot more sophisticated today. There are so many new financial products out there. 20 years ago, my father could probably manage his family money because it was just about going to the FD and what rate of return and what tenure. Mutual funds are not that simple. I mean, there are some 20 categories of equity and hybrid schemes out there and some so many categories of fixed income schemes. You just need advice to keep up with capital markets. Item one. The second reason you need advice is that every individual is different. Your needs are very different from my needs, and my needs are very different from my mother's needs and my neighbor's needs. Advice is customized for you. So in all this journey of asset allocation, so much of the answers depend on your circumstances. The details depend on your circumstances. And the third and the most important thing is that finance is a game of behavior. It's really not a game of choosing the best mutual fund. It's about avoiding doing the silly things. It's about avoiding adding to mid caps when everyone in a cocktail party is saying, God, I made so much money in that mid cap fund. And it's about having the courage to hold through in 2008 when every day the world is ending, if you read the news reports. And an external perspective, as it is in life, will help you with that. So those are the three reasons that you need financial advice.
Do you have a view on the type of financial advice? Because now I'm going to just categorize. Mm-hmm. One is I use my own brains.
Yeah.
Okay. And the second is, let's forget the first part. And the second is whether I go through, I think it's called a robo-advisor, yeah, or something, or some, you know, some app, which doesn't really have a human interface. Okay. Mm-hmm. Or I actually hunt out for a actual human being. Do you have a view on this, or it doesn't really make a difference whether you're going here or going there?
I have a view, and, you know, call me biased, but I have a view, and I think money is very personal. And I do believe human advice is far more powerful. If you look at most robo-advice, and not to take away much from them, it can't be customized beyond a point. As I said, a 25-year-old like me who was going to start a business has very different asset allocation and financial advice goals from a 25-year-old working at a big bank who has a stable stream of income. No robo will be able to figure that out. No robo could have figured it out for me back in 2006 and 7. So that's why I think the human intervention is important. Also recall what I said about behavior, right? A robo can't control your behavior. A human can. A human provides an external perspective. And it's funny, you know, we don't talk about robos in so many other domains. We're often very uncomfortable with a robo doing surgery or providing us medical advice, right?
I would not. I'm going to a doctor.
You're going to the doctor,
right? I'm going to Google. I stop that stuff, okay? Because every time I go on Google and check a symptom, I'm getting cancer. I'm like, I'm done with that. I'm not going to go to Google on that. So I get what you're saying.
So if health is important, then so is wealth, right? So you're not going to Google how to go get a knee surgery done. You're probably not going to Google if you have a serious legal problem that you're in. You're going to find the best lawyer in town and help you out. So money is equally important and equally personal.
So, my view or what I think is that a great financial advisor is actually going to handhold you. Okay, he's going to, you know, take you through the entire emotional upheavals of both the sides. When your stock portfolio is doing fantastically well and when your stock portfolio is just going for your toss. I shouldn't say stock portfolio, but I mean in an overall portfolio. Tell me, how do these advisors help you with asset allocations? And if there is maybe a checklist of three or four questions that listeners can look out for in a very good financial advisor. Because, you know, like anything else, like you're choosing a good doctor, you take recommendations, you take advice, and, you know, you not all the times you land up with a good doctor. Maybe after running through many doctors, you finally land up with someone that you completely trust. Okay, so the value of financial advice, just maybe a few questions that could help our listeners ask the potential people that they're meeting to provide them with financial advice.
So I'll take your first part first, which is what can a financial advisor do in terms of asset allocation? And then I'll come to how to choose a financial advisor. I think what a financial advisor can do is firstly, listen to you, hear what your plan is, maybe for 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Understand from you through a set of probing questions what your kind of risk appetite is. And, you know, as financial services professionals, you get that sense. Based on that, he can devise an asset allocation for you. So he can tell you those four asset classes that you need. He can tell you, you know, should you be 75, 25? He can help you monitor it when markets move up and down. And he can force you to trust the process and he can customize it as your life changes. Say you went from salaried to being unemployed, or say you went from salaried to having to run a business, or say you got married or wanted to plan for your kids' education. He can work through this with all of you, review your portfolio on a frequent basis, get you up to speed with new things also that are coming into the market. So that's all that he can do for you. So there's quite a bit that someone can do. How to choose? I think there are about three things that I would advise listeners. One is that it's so much about trust. Whether it's a lawyer, whether it's a doctor, whether it's a financial advisor, there's a chemistry in trust. And the person sitting opposite the table is someone that you've got to trust. And trust is something that will be established in a conversation. Don't rush to find someone. Have 5-6 conversations with them. The most trusted financial advisors are transparent ones. I often get these questions that are financial advisors in this to make money? Mm. You know, I mean, you get this a lot. So I'm addressing it up front. I see good ones, I see bad ones, but there are more good ones than bad ones. A lot of guys, having been an entrepreneur myself, are self-made entrepreneurs. They have their reputations on the line. One thing to see in a financial advisor, for instance, to gauge trust is his longevity. How long has he been in that business? Mm. I think that is helpful.
Fantastic. I'm going to wrap up this third part and our series. Okay, there is one, of course, the standard ending, which I will come to later. Tell us about Edelweiss Asset Management. You know, just tell us about the company that you work for and the kind of schemes that it has. Where can listeners reach out to you, to Edelweiss, to know more about them, and how your company has asset allocation, has probably all the options of asset allocation within it. Tell us.
Sure. So Edelweiss is, of course, a large financial services institution. We have multiple lines of businesses, and the asset management business, I would like to say we are a young, dynamic asset management company. On a consolidated basis, about 20,000 crores is what we manage. And we try to be very, very simple and responsible in what we do. We have a wide range of products today. So we have equity products, we have fixed income products, and if you want to build a simple asset allocation, we'll have all the solutions, whether it's a good large cap fund or a top performing mid cap fund or a liquid fund, all of that is there. One of the things that Edelweiss is very passionate about is a third category of fund. So a third way to do asset allocation outside of doing it yourself and a financial advisor is use asset allocation funds. Hmm. There is a category of funds that SEBI has created called dynamic asset allocation / balanced advantage funds.
Oh, okay.
And these are funds that basically take your equity and debt and give you some equity and some debt. And remember what I said about taking advantage of different market conditions?
Yes, yes.
They allocate your assets to equity and debt automatically depending on market conditions.
Right.
So we've got a fund in that category called Edelweiss Balanced Advantage Fund. By the way, that's where I invest a lot of my money now.
Full disclosure.
After all my asset allocation mistakes. So for many investors, especially first-time investors, and it's not just Edelweiss. I mean, this fund category exists.
You've got skin in the game, as they say. You're actually investing in the
business. It's really close to my heart. So I think it just takes away a lot of your problems. And if you want a simple solution, you know, for me, that balanced advantage fund is a little bit of a simple solution.
Okay.
And so we've got a full suite of hybrid kind of funds, asset allocation funds. Balanced advantage one is the, you know, favorite that I mentioned. There's another one that's great for starter investors who want to graduate from FD to something a little more. It takes 1/3 of your money in equities, 1/3 in fixed income, and 1/3 in arbitrage, which is the equivalent of fixed income. So your starting equities, as I said, by jumping into a kiddie pool, not into a diving pool.
Hmm. Okay.
So look at us for these kind of solutions. These are automatic ways to do asset allocation at the very basic.
Fantastic. The website is edelweiss.com?
edelweissmf.com, and you can find us on Twitter at edelweissamc.
And your handle is iradhikagupta?
iradhikagupta.
And I'm going to add two more things to that, okay? You guys have to check two videos of Radhika. One is called The Girl with a Broken Neck. It was at an event, I think, of Reliance GCS.
Yes, Reliance GCS.
I don't know what GCS means, but it's
it's a security arm, but it's their internal kind of TED platform that they created.
That's what I was wondering. I was wondering, what's that talk doing at a Reliance security thing?
Okay,
Reliance is TED platform. The title of the YouTube video is The Girl with the Broken Neck. Completely fascinating. The second video, specifically on asset allocation, is at the Cafe Mutual event?
Yes, it's Cafe Mutual 2017. So if you want to look up the YouTube one, it's Cafe Mutual's 2017. It was done for financial advisors. It was actually my first video 6 days into being an AMC CEO. So it's a very special video.
Wow. Yeah, yeah. Please. So there you go, folks. Those are the two videos that you should check out. Both of them are really worth your time in getting to know our guest, Radhika, and also her entire Edelweiss's approach to the asset allocation process. Radhika, thank you. And this is the end. There are two standard questions at the end of all our shows that we ask. And this is the fun part, okay? First, what is your biggest mistake so far in life? And what did it teach you?
My biggest mistake, which I continue to make, is not to be patient enough. I am a very impatient person in life. Not with money, but in life. So be patient, because life does work out in life and with money. And so I've done lots of things where I get impatient that things are not going according to plan. 6 months, 12 months later, they do. But I'm very edgy and I'm very impatient. So be patient.
What do you do to cope with impatience?
What do I do to cope with impatience? You will make fun of me for this. I'm learning Urdu and I write and I read poetry.
My God.
It calms me down.
That is so cool. Okay, what poetry is that? Rumi or something?
Rumi, Purane, old Urdu gazals, old Urdu poets. I read Faiz and Nida Fazli and it calms me down.
Calms you down.
Yeah,
anything.
Totally.
But that's really interesting. And what content, okay, it could be movie, music, book, YouTube, Netflix, whatever it is, would you recommend as a must, consume to our listeners to help them make better decisions in money and finance?
Okay, so there's a great book, and I do some talks on this. It's called Nudge by Richard Thaler. And it talks about the fact that basically we're human, right? And because we're human, we do silly things, even though, you know, we shouldn't. We're lazy. We opt for the default. Let me give you a very quick example. You know, when you install a Windows software, you get two options, custom and recommended, right? I mean, default and recommended. You always pick the default, right? So it talks about these biases that we have as human beings and how you can do small, small things to just overcome those biases. For instance, automating your investments. Instead of doing 3-year SIPs, make the default in your SIPs perpetual. So Nudge is a great book. I highly recommend everyone reads it. It has tons of applications.
Richard Thaler, I think, is a Nobel Prize winner.
He's a Nobel Prize winner for economics.
It's fantastic for behavioral finance.
Yep.
You know, and it's a great book to keep alongside with maybe a Daniel Kahneman, Thinking Fast and Slow. Anything else?
No, that's my favorite. I mean, otherwise, I think YouTube is fantastic. TEDx has some fantastic talks. Maybe I'm a little biased because I like format.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of good video content online. You find inspiration in great things. I find inspiration in graduation speeches.
I find inspiration in your story.
Thank you.
It's just so fantastic to hear, you know. And you've been, you know, the video just says it all, right? The girl with the broken neck. And that story, I hope all of you check out that YouTube video and know of Radhika's story. Radhika, thank you so much. This has been just such a good recording, all three parts on asset allocation. And I'm sure that if listeners have any follow-up questions, they can reach out to you, reach out to Edelweiss on social media, or reach out to me and I'll pass on the questions to Radhika and Edelweiss. Folks, thank you so much for listening. Radhika, thank you so much for taking out your time.
Thank you. It was really awesome. And we look forward to hearing lots of your questions.
Listeners, do ask the questions. See you around.
No material on the show should be considered as financial advice. The material on the show is for informational purposes only. Please consult a financial advisor before taking any investment decision.
How aware do you think you are of your laws and rights? Do you look up to laws when you are caught up in situations? Do you know what your rights are when you're stuck somewhere bad? Well, here's a show that can help you move an inch closer to being aware of what your rights are. Tune into Know Your Kanoon with me, Amber Rana. This is a podcast meant to answer all your law-related queries. Catch Know Your Kanoon every week on the IVM website or the app or anywhere you get your podcast from.
Who said healthy food is boring? Who said raw veggies is just salads? Who said eating fats makes you fat? Look forward to my recommendations on healthy food and exercise hacks on the Kinetic Living podcast with me, Coach Urmi, every Wednesday on the IVM app, website, and anywhere you get your podcast from.